Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The academic procession will now enter the venue. You may please rise and remain standing till all the members of the procession take their seats. May I request those of you who are having their cell phones with them to please turn these off for the duration to avoid disturbance to the proceedings. Please rise.
Stretches its arms to us. not lost its way into the dreary deserts and of their habit.
Oh.
of their habit. where the mind is without fear, and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit.
May I request all the dignitaries and all the members on the dais, ladies and gentlemen and graduating students, to please take their respective seats.
May I now request the Chairman, Board of Governors, to please start the proceedings.
I declare the convocation open.
May I request the director, IIM Rohtak, to please welcome the chief guest.
Thank you, sir. May I also request the director, IIM Rohtak, to please welcome the guest of honor.
May I now request the director, IIM Rohtak, to please welcome the chairman, Board of Governors, IIM Rohtak.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the invocation. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. May I now request Professor Dheeraj Sharma, Director, IIM Rohtak, to present the welcome address and the director's report.
Namaste, good morning. It is indeed a great honor and a pleasure to host as our chief guest, Honorable Mr. Justice Rajesh Bindal, sir, Judge, Supreme Court of India, and also Baron Karan Bilamoria, Baron Billamoria, as the title goes. Mr. Cullen Billamoria is CBE, Member, House of Lords, United Kingdom, and also one of the renowned businessmen of Indian origin in the UK. I'm also grateful to have the presence of Chairman BOG of IIM Rohtak, Sri Jay Shroff. Thank you very much, all three of you, for taking out your time and coming to our ceremony and being part of it to congratulate the graduating batch and the largest batch so far of IIM Rohtak. Congratulations, everybody. As my duty to present before you the director's report, I'll just touch on key highlights of what we have accomplished in the last year. This year, we are graduating our largest batch in the history of IIM Rohtak. I can share with you that we started with a batch of 50 students about in 2010 when the first batch came in, and now becoming the largest IIM this year amongst all the IIMs in terms of number of students is a considerable achievement that I believe will make every single person of IIM Rohtak very proud, and also every single member of the community very proud. Despite media reports on the economic conditions and economic situation, several reports being carried out, I'm very proud to announce that IIM Rohtak has completed 100% placement again this year. And with our historic high of CTC of 48.25 lakh rupees, an average salary of approximately 19 lakh per annum, which is 2.8% higher than the last year's average. Congratulations. It is a considerable testimony of the work of our placement committee, as well as the administration of the placement office, that we got more than 230 companies coming to IIM Rohtak. It's a testimony in itself that how IIM Rohtak is making strong progress with connections with industry. 230 plus companies, an incredible achievement. This is 70 more than last year. This is one of the greatest achievements, I would say, for our year, concluding this March. In terms of publications, our faculty has done extraordinarily well. IIM Rohtak prides that all our doctoral students who graduate are required to have an A category publication on an international list. We were the only IIM to have that requirement, and now other IIMs are also catching up to that. This is a demonstration that our faculty continues to produce in collaboration with our doctoral students' highest quality research, which is not just impactful in industry, but also in public policy. Over the course of last year, we had several executive education programs. We have done training programs for Government of India, for Bureau of Indian Standards, very many PSUs, many programs for different agencies, including CAPF, the Haryana Police, Haryana Administrative Service Officers, and many others. And also, we were the first ones to do one of the best programs so far to train the educational leadership of central higher education institutions, which we concluded only 2 weeks ago. So this also demonstrates that not just in terms of research, but also in terms of executive education and training, the institution is taking great strides, starting in 2017, with an executive education revenue of only 5 lakhs, we are touching executive education and consulting revenue of more than 10 crores every year. This is a significant achievement. During the year, we had 113 visiting and adjunct professors, out of which more than 80 were from abroad. This again shows our efforts towards internationalization and shows that we are willing to get the best brains from across the world to give the best possible education to our students in our institution. We have had collaboration and interactions and also MOUs with Oxford University of Hindu Studies, with Ryerson University, University of Bath, Lancaster University, Leeds Beckett University, Zurich University, among others. Several other institutions have had arrangements with us to have faculty exchange, and now we are exploring going forward a student exchange. I'm sure that we'll try to work out feasibility of this student exchange so that students can avail exposure of international education system as well as international industry in the forthcoming batches. Our students are our backbone. Our PGP students, our students who come from the integrated program,
are the brightest of the bright. I'm not just saying it because they are in our institution. I am personally witness to some of their growth and some of the work that they have done. Student clubs, student activities are an integral part of IIM Rohtak community. Our students continue to contribute in numerous ways, not just participating in contests across institutions, but also within the institution. They work so hard that our students continue to remain engaged. And many people would say that our students only sleep for about 5 hours a day. I believe that's an overstatement. I think it's around 4. Our students continue to participate in so many different activities, including organizing TEDx, Film Summit, and also organizing cultural events every single year. For all the festivals of India, they have their individual celebrations, and they have so many different mechanisms to interact with the forthcoming batch, the new batch which comes in, and they contribute towards passing on the baton of the culture of IIM Rohtak to the new batches. And I'm sure I invite you all that during the orientation program, if you're interested, we will welcome you back to have interaction with the new batch so that you can pass on the baton again formally and interact with them and tell them about IIM culture, because the backbone of our institution is our culture, and we take great pride in this culture. Also graduating are 38 students of the second batch of the BBA. This program is a unique program because we were the first ones, I repeat, because another IIM had a program, but at that point in time, we were not allowed to have degrees. The IIM Act had not passed. We were the first IIM to start the BBA MBA program, and now this BBA MBA program is now, I believe, offered in at least 6 to 7 other IIMs. Our students in that program are extraordinary. I must tell you, last year received close to 20,000 applications and only about 165 got in. This is a remarkable testimony of their progress. They come shoulder to shoulder with our MBA students, contribute tremendously in cultural activities, curricular, extracurricular, as well as academic activities. I also want to congratulate the doctoral students who are graduating. Our doctoral program is expanding every year. We have gone from 1 or 2 students to about 14 or 15 students last batch. We will be inducting this year. We are anticipating we'll induct about 12 to 15 doctoral students. Our doctoral program is fully residential and supported by the institution itself. It's a great pride for us that we use our own funds. We are no longer for last several years receiving any funding from the government, and we have chosen a path to self-sustain ourselves. We have generated our own funds, and we continue to support our doctoral program, which is fully funded, fully residential, given a stipend for a period of 4 to 5 years, who come on our campus and considerably participate in our research endeavors and produce cutting-edge research as they have done during the COVID, and also contribute meaningfully in several projects which we have undertaken for Ministry of Agriculture, Ministry of Consumer Affairs, DGFT, Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of Haryana, among others. We have organized several conferences last year, and we continue to do the same. In closure, I would like to congratulate all the students, and not just the students, but their parents, whose sacrifices have made all of this possible. If I have a piece of advice to students, it'll be twofold. First, if you can't take care of your parents, your education is useless. Your first and primary responsibility is to take care of your parents, because they have sacrificed so much to have you here, to give you a pedestal, which allows you a shield to at least do, you can't go below that, you can only go higher. Second, I would suggest that you find a why, because in the words of Nietzsche, if you have a why to live, you can persevere with almost any how. I repeat, if you have a why to live, you can persevere with any how. Find a why and you will have a successful life ahead. Remain connected with the institution, love your parents, love your family, support the community, and support IIM Rohtak. Congratulations, Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. May I now request the Chairman Board of Governors, IIM Rohtak, to kindly deliver his address.
Honorable Chief Justice, guest of honor of the ceremony, members of the board, director, faculty, students, staff of IIM Rohtak, parents, distinguished guests, ladies, gentlemen, I welcome you at this 13th convocation of IIM Rohtak. We wish to express our gratitude to the chief guest and the guest of honor for being with us at this event. Sir, we extend our warmest welcome to you. Your presence today itself is auspicious and will encourage us all to make a strong commitment for the future development of this campus. Convocation is a combination of a journey as well as a moment of renewal for the Institute. It is its students, faculties, members, parent bodies, and others who are part of this institution. I wholeheartedly congratulate all the students of the Institute who are graduating today from one of the fastest growing management institutes of the country. I take this opportunity to congratulate each of you 361 students from the PGP, DPM, and IPM passing out today. I hope that you enjoyed your stay in this institution. I have been informed that all of you have been placed well, starting from 50 students in its first batch in PGP. The Institute has come a long way to the present students' strength of over 1,700 students across long-duration programs. It is an incredible achievement for the Institute. I would appeal to the graduating students to keep the interest of the institution in mind and stay connected and active in the alumni. I also recognize the efforts of the role and the roles played by the faculty and staff in getting IIM Rohtak to where it is today. In spite of the working under challenging circumstances all these years, the faculty have produced outstanding work in leading prestigious journals and publications and seminars. I appreciate the determination of Professor Sharma, director of IIM Rohtak, who has created a remarkable trajectory for the institution in such a short span of his tenure. Now having its own campus, state-of-the-art architecture, and all the world-class facilities, the Institute is able to provide a cherishing environment to its students with an essential for learning and development. I am glad to share that IIM Rohtak has done an exceptionally well in improving public perception of students and parents about this institute. IIM Rohtak attained historic numbers in terms of gender diversity. The institute has taken several breathtaking initiatives at IIM Rohtak over the last few years. We have envisioned IIM Rohtak Gurgaon campus as one of the finest urban campuses in the country that will provide a thriving environment for management education. It is very important for the institution to provide a dynamic learning environment to its students. The right collaboration of physical, digital, innovative, and academic infrastructure leads to favorable learning condition. There has been strong evidence that the high quality facilities that lead to better interaction, improve student outcome, and reduce dropout rates, among other benefits. The academic and co-curricular activities at such campuses can thrive with complete ease. Thus, the ideal academic atmosphere contributes to students' personal development and social well-being. We are committed to providing a campus that will empower students to create strong linkages with academia, industry, and government. I am confident that under the guiding leadership of the present Board of Governors and execution by the Institute's administration under the leadership of Professor Sharma, we will be able to make IIM Rohtak one of the best global management institutes. The board has rewarded Professor Sharma with an appropriate, duly approved variable pay package each year. We are now conveyed the new targets to him. These targets will focus on internationality of IIM Rohtak, expand the capacity in terms of batch size and development of Gurgaon campus. I am also proud of the fact that IIM Rohtak has introduced some of the highly exceptional breakthrough programs situated at the epicenter of business activity in Delhi NCR. IIM Rohtak has worked diligently in association with business and policy makers to provide an excellent education base and research for the benefit of society. For the graduating students, this is a special moment. It is a realization of hard work, sacrifice put by you as students, by your professors and teachers, and by your parents and families that have supported and stood by you. About to enter the world with packed with opportunities. A world which this institute has prepared you. I urge you to adopt a multi-dimensional approach in life. This shall include dimensions like empathy, humanity in the thought process. At the end, I would like to thank the chief guest of honor for their gracious presence. I thank the Ministry of Education for giving us unstinted support and guidance, guiding the institute. I would also like to thank the parents and graduating students to allow their wards to come to Rohtak. I thank Professor Sharma for being the great catalyst and the leader. The faculty of the input and their inputs, open-minded for the youngsters. The staff for their commitment and hard work. And finally, I would like to thank the students for being the life and soul of the institute. I once again congratulate the graduating students and appeal to them to support the institute in future and future growth and development, and wish them all the best in their future endeavors. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. May I now request the guest of honor to deliver his address.
You have come into this hall as graduands. You will leave in a short while as graduates. So many congratulations to all of you. Not only that, you're the largest cohort in this 13th graduation ceremony of IIM Rohtak. Now at 1,700 students within 15 years. What an achievement. Something you should be very proud of. And credit for this goes to the leadership of this wonderful institution led by Professor Dheeraj Sharma, your dynamic director. I met him in Dubai through my mutual friend, Dr. Aman Puri, who was the Consul General in Dubai, and before that, the Consul General in Birmingham for India. And I'm proud to be Chancellor of the University of Birmingham, one of our Russell Group Ivy League universities in the UK, one of the top 100 universities in the world, 40,000 students, and I'm the first Indian-born Chancellor of a Russell Group university in the UK. We have a campus in Dubai now, and I'm hopeful that we will have a partnership with IIM Rohtak going forward with our campus in Dubai. Fingers crossed. I would like to thank your chairman, Mr. Jay Shroff, your faculty, and of course, the chief guest, Justice Rajesh Bindal. It's an honor to share the platform with all of you. And for being at IIM Rohtak, for me, to being at a business school is like coming home, because I'm a proud alumnus of three business schools. I'm an alumnus of the Cranfield School of Management, I'm an alumnus of the London Business School, and I'm an alumnus of Harvard Business School. And for 5 years, I chaired the advisory board of the Cambridge Judge Business School. I'm a visiting fellow at the Said Business School at Oxford and an honorary ambassador for the Cambridge Judge Business School. So business schools are part of my life. And I remember my final lecture at Harvard. We're about to become alumni after that lecture. And we were addressed by Professor Clay Christensen, one of the greatest business school professors ever. And he gave us this advice in that lecture, and I wish I had been to that lecture earlier in my life. And he said to every one of us, "Have you stopped and thought, what is the purpose of my life?" And I ask each one of you now as you're graduating, what is the purpose of your life? And linked to that, how will you measure your life? There is no right or wrong answer. It's an individual question, an individual answer. Keep asking those questions all your life, because the purpose is the most important thing. I remember when I left India as a 19-year-old, I already had a BCom honors degree. I qualified as a chartered accountant with EY, with Ernst & Young in London. I did a law degree at Cambridge University, and then I started my business, Cobra Beer. Now, I'm proud to say a third of a century later, and I boast with pride, by the way. Please forgive me if I boast, but I boast with pride. At Harvard, they said, be confident, but not arrogant. Be ambitious, but be humble. Be humbitious. So humbitiously, I say, Cobra Beer is now a household name in the UK and has won 145 gold medals, making it one of the best in the world and the most famous consumer brand of Indian origin in the United Kingdom, and I'm proud of that. I'm an entrepreneur. How many of you will start your own business one day? Can I see a show of hands? How many of you think you will start your own business? Fantastic. But I tell you, there's one word that describes entrepreneurs more than any other word. Guts. Those who put your hands up, you've got to have the guts to do it and sacrifice whatever other opportunity you have. But more importantly, an entrepreneurial journey is never easy. It's up and down. I've nearly lost my business 3 times. You've got to have the guts to stick with it when others would give up. Now, you've heard, I've attended 3 business schools. You're graduating from a business school. What's the bet? You've never done a case study on luck. I've done hundreds of case studies, but I've never done a case study on luck. And luck comes into life. There's good luck and there's bad luck. Hopefully it'll be good luck. And the best definition of luck that I've ever heard was in the Harvard Business School classroom. Luck is when determination meets opportunity. If you're not determined, you won't even see the opportunity. And I picture it like waves going past me in life. And if you're lucky, if you're determined, you might just catch one of those waves. If you're not, those waves will go past you all your life. So be determined and get lucky. Now I'm going to ask you a question. Be honest with me. How many of you think you're creative? If you think you're creative, put your hand up. If you think you're not creative, keep your hands down. Can I just see a show of hands? Creative? Very good. This is a much better result, by the way. Thank you. Around the world, it's usually half the hands that go up. I was told as a child, Karan, you're doing well academically, keep going, you should do well, but you're not creative. Why? I couldn't draw. I was useless at art. They forced me to play the piano. I passed grade one. Then they said, please stop. Please spare us your tone deaf. I was not creative. I was told I was not creative all through my youth, all through my studies. And it's only when I became an entrepreneur that I realized I'm actually very creative and had been suppressed throughout my youth. Be confident to be creative. It is the most important skill in life to be creative and innovative. And in fact, my father, who was a senior general, he became commander-in-chief of the Central Army in India. When he gave advice to me when I first started work, he said, son, you're starting at the bottom. You'll be given lots of tasks. Do the tasks. But most importantly, do that little bit extra that you were not asked to do. And that's the best advice I've been given in my life. Because my father was saying, be creative, be innovative, take the initiative, and always go the extra mile. Trust. Do you know something? You've only got where you've got to here, not just because of your hard work, but because of your friends helping you, and most importantly, your faculty helping you, and most importantly, your family helping you. So I'd like the graduates to give your family and your faculty a huge round of applause to thank them. And Professor Francis Fry at Harvard Business School gave us a one-hour lecture on trust, and I will summarize that to you in 1 minute. To get trust from people is like a triangle. You've got to be authentic, the real you. You've got to have the logic and capability to deliver what you're promising to deliver. And finally, you've got to have empathy. Are you in it for yourself, or are you in it for them? Authentic, logic, empathy, and you can get people's trust. So be proud of graduating from IIM Rohtak. Be proud of graduating from an IIM. You're graduating from a very strong brand. And I tell you, the three times I nearly lost my business, the three things that got me through, one was having a strong brand. The next was having the support of my family, my wife. Without her support, I wouldn't be here talking to you today. And my loyal team who supported me, but also integrity. It is better to fail doing the right thing than to succeed doing the wrong thing. So strong brand, family, and integrity. And my last bits of advice to you are this. When you walk out of this hall, yes, you'll be leaving IIM Rohtak, but actually, you're never leaving. This is Hotel California. You can check out anytime you want, but you can never leave, because you are forever a member of the IIM Rohtak family and alumni community for life, and put back into the institution, not just in money, donate back, but in mentoring and being a perpetual ambassador for this wonderful institution that you're graduating from. And next, be proud of what India is achieving today. The Indian Express has left the station. It is now the fastest growing major economy in the world. And I predict that by 2060, India will be the largest economy in the world. So I'm proud to be a Zoroastrian Parsi. I'm proud to be British. I'm proud to be an Asian in Britain. But most importantly, I'm really, really proud to be Indian. So the learning never stops. One of my favorite sayings of Mahatma Gandhi, live as if you're going to die tomorrow. Learn as if you're going to live forever. So never stop learning, keep learning. And our motto at Cobra Beer, my motto and my coat of arms in the House of Lords, is to aspire and achieve. Aspire and achieve against all odds with integrity. And finally, this is the last bit of advice I give to you. It's been a privilege to be with you. believe in yourselves. Because as Mahatma Gandhi said, your beliefs become your thoughts become your words become your actions become your habits form your character, and your character determines your destiny. Congratulations. Thank you.
Candidate for the award of Doctor of Philosophy, please rise. The candidate will individually receive her degree from the chief guest and guest of honor as I call her name, and then return to her seat and remain standing. May I please request the dignitaries on the dais to please come in front of the desk to award degrees. Ms. Shweta, thesis title, Impact of Work Passion on Individual Career Outcomes, Transitioning from Passionate to Non-Passionate Occupations. Honorable Chairman, upon the recommendation of the Academy Council, I have the honor to present Ms. Shweta and one other who have successfully completed the prescribed course of studies and fulfilled all other requirements for the award of Doctor of Philosophy, and request the Indian Institute of Management Rohtak to confer the degree on the candidate, of whom one is present and one will receive the degree in absentia.
Members of the Academic Council, may the Doctorate of Philosophy be conferred on the DPM scholars.
All candidates for the award of Master of Business Administration, please rise. The candidates will individually receive their degree from the chief guest as I call their names, and then return to their seats and remain standing. A. Ritika. Achal Singh. Ashi Arya. Aves Sajjad Hussain. Ayushi. Abhishek Gupta. Abhya Singh. Aditi Khobragade. Aditi Sen. Aishwarya Mahatme. Alisha Ahmed. Aman Jain. Amisha. Amrita Datta. Amrita Shaji. Amruta R. Anita Anish Pandey, Anjana Raj, Ankur Ganeriwala, Ankurita Debnath, Anmol, Anne Maria Reni, Anna Mary Sangama, Ansab Khan, Ansh Rajput, Anshul Garg, Anupam Biswas, Anupriya Singh, Anurag Chaudhary, Aparajita Ghosh, Apurva S. Raghavan, Ashish, Ashu Gupta, Ashutosh Lakra, Athena Chaudhary, Aisha Parveen, Ayush Raut, Ayushi Jain, Ayushi Kondal, Barsha Agarwal, Bhagyashri Jain, Bhanu Pratap Singh, Bhumika Kabi, Bhupesh Garg, Bhuvna Chandrika Boburu, Catherine Nikita, Chaitanya Chavla, Chandrika Deb, Chirayu Puri, Daisy Khurania, Debole Day, Dipanshu Dalal, Dhruv Sharma, Diksha Khandelwal, Dinesh Garg, Divya Dinesh Ghotke, Divya Shankar Prem, Doki Parthi Sai Sandeep, Drishti Bose, Gargi Shara, Gipika, Govindam Rastogi, Guncha Malhotra, Gunjan Parmar, Hardik Kapoor, Harsh Maheshwari, Hitesh Shatani, Isha Pokharyal, Jadhav Varya Virendra, Jaiswar Sahil Madhukar, John Samuel M. Juhi Werner, Jumala Roshni, Kagitpu Somya, Kanha Agarwal, Kanupriya Yadav, Karan Sidana, Kashish Jaiswal, Kavya Arya, Kavya Gupta, Khushbu Puri, Khyati Patel, Kiran P, Komal Kamtaria, Kritika Verma, Kritika Bhatt, Chitij Amit Shah, Chitit Singh, Kukutlawar Mahesh Kumar Shankar, Kunika Jaiswal, Lauren Benny Naguli, M. Shivani Roy, Madhumita Kumar, Mahalakshmi V, Mahale Rutuja Dilip, Mayanglam Joshita Devi, Mayank Mishra, Meghna Bomidi, Mehul Mehta, Mihir Raja, Mohammad Shoaib Ansar, Mohit Jain, Monali Bambode,
Nancy Paharia. Namra Rauf. Narvola Bhagyashree. Navneet Paliwal. Neha Biswas. Neha Chaudhary. Nancy Patel. Nikhil Saini. Nilanjan Mukherjee. Nirmala Vaishalini. Nishant Gupta. Nishal Kumar Sharma. Ojas Singhal. Pagdar Chalchal Ashwin. Parneet Kaur. Patwa Akanksha Santosh. Piyali Mishram. Purnima H. Pragya Kaushal. Pranjal Mittal. Prathamesh Agarwal. Pratiksha Gedam. Preeti Bai. Priyal Maheshwari. Priyam Patodi. Puru Raj Raghuvanshi. R. Uma Sai Pragna. Radhika Mukati. Raghav Mittal. Rajanshu Dhiman. Rashi Yadav. Rashmi Timung. Ria Angelina Tatwal. Rio Sojan. Rishabh. Rishabh Agarwal. Ria. Ria Bisht. Ria Sharma. Sachin Ansal. Sagarika Saini. Sakshi Dambare. Samarth Kuhar. Sambhav Modgil. Sanskriti Sisodia. Sanya Arora. Sanya Chauhan. Satya Prakash Singh, Sejal Padia, Shah Riya Ben Rakesh Kumar, Shalmali Takle, Shardul Singh Rajput, Sheila Danita S, Shelly Jain, Shraddha Gavare, Shridipta Biswas, Shruti Yadav, Shruti Dhara Devrai, Shubhi Saxena, Siddharth, Siddharth Pathak, Simran R. Chandra, Soham Manoj Chorghe, Somil Jain, Sonali, Srijani Bagchi, Subhana Handik, Swarangi Savant, Swastik Sanyal, Tanmay Gopal, Tanu Verma, Tanya Gupta, Tanya Srivastav, Tarini Pratiksha M, Thati Vani, Utkarsh Nigam, Vaibhav Gupta, Vaishali Ji, Vaishnavi Varshne, Vandit Jain, Vansh Ehlawat, Vansh Pavdia, Vedika Luhariwala, Vibhi, Vibhor Jain, Vishakha Bhatt, Vishal Kamdar, W. Catherine Beth, Yash Bharadwaj, Yogi Basotia, Arya Vijay, Ayush Verma, Abhigyan Mishra, Aditya Meghlani, Advait, Akanksha Shiva, Akshara Sharma, Akshay Khanna, Alok Kumar, Ananya BK, Anisha Gupta, Ankit Kumar Chaudhary, Arshia Mahajan, Ashutosh Parihar, Ayushi Priya, Bachala Shrihita, Chaitanya Aryan Elawat, Chanchala Patrol, Chirag Agarwal, Chirag Sharda, Chukhu Nayu, Deepsi Pradeep Salgaonkar, Dhruv Bansal, Dishita Mittal, Drishti Chawla, Faiz Mohammed, Gaurang Narayani, Randi Rashmi Harika, Guru Siddharth, Hari Keshav Ramodu, Ishan Sharma, Ishika Soni, Juhi Agarwal, Jyotsna A, Kanishk Rohilan, Karan Yadav, Ketan Thakur, Vishwaraj. Kritika Saran. Lohitaksh Mund. Malivai Ramohan. Manan. Manan Jain. Mayank Bhatt. Mehul Pal. Mohammad Naved Kumar. Mukund Nagarajan Rao. Naman Banka. Navya Ohri. Nayanshi Yadav. Neha Kumari. Nitish Kumar. Pancham Oza. Parth Rastogi. Prateek Rao. Prateek Khilare. Prince. Priyadarshani Rathaur. R. Darun. R. Hari Krishnan. Ramit Pramod Munga. Rituja Singh. Riya Agarwal. Riya Singh. Runjun Sagar. Sadhur Vedalakshmi K. Saksham Katyar. Saloni Kumar. Samir Chauhan. Sandarp Kumar. Shreya Dhamija. Shubh Kumar. Shubhangi Soni. Smith Ladd. Sravan B. Suhani Rana. Surja Sarthi Adya. Swagat Shankar Panigrahi. Swasti Rohila. Swastik Baderia. Tanmay Shubham Pant. Tanya Pant. Tushar Gupta. Ujwal Mathur. Utkarsh Verma. Utkarsh Yadav. Vaibhav Avasthi. Vedika Kumar. Vishakha Shahi. Yashi Khasaria. Yatika Gautam. Mishti. I request the dignitaries to please take their seats. Honorable Chairman, upon the recommendation of the Academic Council, I have the honor to present Ms. A. Ritika and 320 others who have successfully completed the prescribed course of studies and fulfilled all other requirements for the award of the Master of Business Administration, and request the Indian Institute of Management Rohtak to confer the degree on these candidates, of whom 295 are present and 26 will receive the degree in absentia.
May the Masters of Business Administration be conferred on the postgraduate candidates.
All the PGP students are requested to please take their seats.
All candidates for the award of Bachelor of Business Administration, please rise. The candidates will individually receive their degree from the chief guest as I call their names and then return to their seats and remain standing. May I please request the dignitaries on the dais, please come in front of the dais to award the degrees. Arnav Singh. Aryan Prabodh. Bhumika Arora. Muskan Bhola. Nandani Gupta. Shreyas Pathak. Sneha S. Tejas Goyal. Yash Solanke. I request the dignitaries to please take their seat. Honorable Chairman, upon the recommendation of the Academic Council, I have the honor to present Mr. Arnab Singh and 37 others who have successfully completed the prescribed course of studies and fulfilled all other requirements for the award of the Bachelor of Business Administration, and request the Indian Institute of Management Rohtak to confer the degree on these candidates, of whom 9 are present and 29 will receive the degree in absentia.
May the members, may the Bachelors of Business Administration be conferred on the undergraduate candidates.
All the graduating students are requested to please rise.
By the authority given to the Board of Governors under the IIM Act 2017 and on the recommendation of the Academic Council of the Indian Institute of Management Rohtak, DPM students are awarded the Doctorate of Philosophy, PGP students are awarded the Masters of Business Administration, and the BBA students are awarded the Bachelor of Business Administration. And I charge that by the thought, word, and deed, you prove yourself worthy of the award.
The graduating students will now take the oath of honor. I, as a graduate of IIM Rohtak, will take responsibility of my actions and be accountable for its foreseeable consequences. I will hold every other human being in high regard, acknowledging the inherent differences and honoring the rights of others to be treated with dignity. I will act with utmost integrity and pursue my work, upholding the highest ethical standards. This pledge I make freely and upon my honor.
All the graduating students of DPM, PGP, and BB are requested to take their seats.
May I request the dignitaries on the dais to please come in front of the desk to award medals. The Indian Institute of Management Rohtak Gold Medal for the best all-rounder performance has been awarded to Ms. Jyotsna A, who will come forward and receive the medal from the chief guest. The Indian Institute of Management Gold Medal for the best scholastic performance has been awarded to Ms. Sheila Danita S, who will come forward and receive the medal from the chief guest.
The Indian Institute of Management Silver Medal for Best Scholastic Performance has been awarded to Ms. A. Ritika, who will come forward and receive the medal from the guest of honor. The Indian Institute of Management Rohtak Bronze Medal for the Best Scholastic Performance has been awarded to Ms. Vaishnavi Vashne, who will come forward and receive the medal from the guest of honor. I request the medal winners to join for a group photograph with the chief guest, guest of honor, chairman BOG, and the director IIM Rohtak. I request the dignitaries on the dais to please take their seats. IIM Rohtak already provides number of scholarships which are offered by state governments, central government, various commissions and other government bodies. The institute took a major step in 2022 to award scholarship of rupees 2.5 lakh each year to top 10 meritorious students of the PGP program. With the scholarship, nearly 1 in 5 students of IIM Rohtak are receiving some type of scholarship. Ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to announce the names of top 10 CGPA holders of PGP 13th batch who are awarded with a scholarship of rupees 2.5 lakhs. Number 1, Sheila Danita S. with a CGPA of 8.92. Rank 2, A. Ritika with a CGPA of 8.75. Rank 3, Vaishnavi Vashne with a CGPA of 8.63. Rank 4, Ayush Verma with a CGPA of 8.62. 5, Sandarp Kumar with a CGPA of 8.59. Number 6, Jyotsna A with a CGPA of 8.55. Number 7, Navya Ohri with a CGPA of 8.45. Number 8, Nirmala Vaishalini with a CGPA of 8.44. Number 9, Chandrika Deb with a CGPA of 8.43. And number 10, Akshara Sharma with a CGPA of 8.22.
Now, I request Honorable Chief Guest to deliver the convocation address.
First of all, I think all of you should have a big round of applause for your teacher and parents also. So I'll start by reciting. We all know Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah. So this is the respect to the gurus. And what you have achieved today, the credit goes to the teachers only. So we have to start with that. We have on the dais Shri J. Sharoff, Chairman of the Board of Governors, Lord Billy Moria, Dr. Dheeraj, Director, Dheeraj Sharma, Director, and us see that what all happened in that function, though we are all seeing it and capturing maybe for the purpose of sharing with our friends and family members who could not join it. Now, you are the passouts from an institute where if I appear in the entrance test also, maybe I fail. I deem it a great honor and privilege to address this annual convocation of this institute, which has been steadily progressing towards the pursuit of excellence for the last decade. Wherever you are today, the credit goes to your parents who gave you the initial lessons, as we call sanskars, family members, teachers, and the friends. I am thankful to the management for inviting me on this solemn occasion and affording me opportunity to congratulate them in person of their achievements, and the faculty members for having contributed to their overall development. I would also like to congratulate to the proud, extend my greetings to the proud parents who will always cherish these memories throughout their life. Father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, expressed his views on education, and I quote, "What is really required to make democracy function is not knowledge of facts, but right education. And this you get in an educational institution." We regularly see, we all know, a lot of information available on Google and various platforms. Maybe part of it is garbage, some right, some wrong. People are expressing their views on the, and uploading everything. It is only in an institute you can find out the ways, and taught by your teachers, that what is right and what is wrong. This is what the education provides you. Today is the 13th convocation. Many people may be thinking 13 is an unlucky day. This is what I think from the beginning we all have been told, nobody knew what it is. But I don't think it is an unlucky number. If you ask me, I took over as judge of the Supreme Court on 13th February only. And presently, my court is also number 13, which I am sitting. In Chandigarh, because it was planned by a French architect, there is no sector 13, because I started my practice there. In court, yes, initially there was court number 13 in Punjab and Haryana High Court, where I started my career. But later on, one of the chief came, he thought maybe it is unlucky, he changed it to 12A. But now, again, it is back to 13 only. So we should not think that 13 is an unlucky number. I read somewhere in a story on Guru Nanak Dev Ji, when he was working as an accountant at Sultanpur Lodi, he was distributing groceries to people. When he gave groceries to 13th person, he stopped because Gurmukhi and Hindi, we all know, 13 is called Tera. So word 13 is called Tera. That means, and Guru Nanak Dev Ji kept saying, yours, 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 all, every, tera, tera, tera. Triyodashi, in Hindu mythology also, is a special day for Lord Shiva. And in Navratras also, we know how we celebrate special pujas in the Devi temples. If we go to the Indian Institute of Management, I think immediately after independence, we had to set up our own system. And so came the public sector enterprises. And after these were set up, we had a great need of experts on management also, because we needed to manage those institutions, those industries. So first Institute of Management was set up in Calcutta, because at that time it was Calcutta, now it is Kolkata, in 1961, the year I was born. So you see, first institute was set up in Calcutta. And now we have 21 Institute of Management in the country, and this was opened in 2009-10, 12th in rank. And another important part is that because Calcutta was the business hub or the industrial hub pre-independence era, and first Institute of Technology was also set up in West Bengal at Kharagpur a decade before that, 1951, just immediately after independence. Now, one of the most notable distinction of IIM Rohtak is its standing at the largest Indian Institute of Management in the country in terms of number of students. You have 1,700 students in this institute, and coming from various parts of the country. This shows total diversity. Now you will have friends and family, not only throughout the country, but also abroad. Wherever you will go, you will have links everywhere. We generally talk about women empowerment. Education brings empowerment, and with over 78% female students in MBA and more than 50% in integrated programs, the institute is really empowering women. And you have seen the top four positions have gone to the girls. This is how they do. Big round of applause for them. And we could see when the degrees were being distributed, how the entire student community here were cheerful and applauding when the students who got degree, who got first position in their courses. There are many courses being run. Yes. When I attended one of the programs with reference to a law course here, I suggested one thing to Professor Sharma, that why not teach another language also to these students? Because you are not to work in your home state after getting these high qualifications. And wherever you go, you may be benefited if you know more languages. So I think this should be in a practice here. I would suggest again, because you have diversity, you have students from throughout the country. So why not have your own self groups to learn any language you like, which will always help you in your career in future. There are a lot of awards, rankings to the credit of the institute. Professor Sharma has already shared with you, and you all know, because I read that all in your details of the program sent to me. And one of the important part is that this IIM has excelled with an impressive representation amongst the top 2% of the scientists worldwide, according to the 23 ranking released by Stanford University. That's a great achievement. Even though it is a younger IIM as compared to the first one you have seen set up in 1961, and this is 2009, with great achievements, credit of this goes to the director, faculty, and equally to all the students who had put their hard work, because teachers can only guide. Ultimately, you have to put your hard work there. And this is the achievement you have. With 100% placement, I think the package is also shared by the director. It's a great achievement to have 100% campus placement. And what I was told is that on an average, the students who are able to students are able to recoup their MBA tuition fee in IIM Rohtak in less than 18 months of their passing out. It's a great achievement, because otherwise in many courses we see that the fee being paid, many students even after passing out don't get the salary as compared to the fee paid by them monthly or annually. You have been told about the Gurugram campus also. I think that will be another feather in cap of this institute, because having a teaching campus in NCR will certainly bring laurels to this institute. Collaborations, yes, you have been told. I did not repeat that, because I think the way the program is going on, I could see the minute-to-minute program. It's perfectly. This is called time management also. It's very important in your life. Now, so I don't want to delay that part, because my slot is also fixed here. So I will skip some parts, but still, whatever little bit I know, my experience, I'll share with you. In any educational institution, from the very initial age, one goes to be educated. But this education means great thinkers in the past had a clear understanding about education was indeed the very process which lays down the foundation for dharma, righteousness, by removing the cover of ignorance and letting the self inner shine. It was put remarkably by Greeks with the proclamation, I quote, "Education should devise the simplest and most effective method to turn the mind towards the light, not to implant sight in it because it already has the capacity, but to correct its orientation because it is now improperly aligned and is not facing the right way." This is what the teachers teach you. In respect of marks and divisions, you may have secured, let me quote,
what noted historian Alan Toynbee once said, I quote, "It is both absurd and unjust to classify a person once for all as being first class or third class when he is only 22 years old. There are slow goers who blossom late in life, and conversely, there are brilliant starters who fail to fulfill their early promises." Toynbee goes on to give an example of Wilson Churchill, who was apparently backward as a child but brilliant as a young man, and a failure once again in middle age to become an admittedly great man in his 60s. We have examples of our Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru also, to which heights they reached, we all know. Today you will get your degrees of an educational qualification. This will give you eligibility for a job. But a real spark success will come from practical experience, which you will gain if you work hard. Your process of learning should not stop, but a new chapter has started. Never think you are an expert. Always be receptive to new ideas. Now I can share, because I had gone in one training program. You may be thinking that we also need training, because training is one part. I think it's a continuous education. We call it continuous judicial education. We have our own academies where regularly we also go, maybe for lectures, or at some places we also go to attend some courses. So in one of the courses I had gone, in one of the subjects there was adult education. But I thought that adult education in our times when we were little younger used to be to teach the adults or the senior citizens living in the rural areas some ABCD or Hindi alphabets so that they can read and write some letters and all that. I'm talking about that era. And the Hindi name used to be the Prod Siksha, some scheme or something. But when the class went on, we had a teacher, I think, from somewhere South Africa in that. If I remember, the name was Mr. He was also a judge there, Peter Jamdar, having origin in India only. So what he taught was that at the young age, when a child goes to the school, his slate is clean. He has curiosity to learn everything. The moment you go adult, your curiosity to learn is there, but you know a lot of things. And your intake is what you want to take out of any lecture. You can't be feed in with anything. So there the issue comes that at every stage of life, they said you have to learn, then unlearn also, and thereafter relearn also. So if that process continues, your mindset, your rigidity will not be there. You will always progress in life. This is what we were in class, so we were told. And we all know this in computers also. You also format, you delete the garbage in the computer. You format your hard disk also. Why? Because you want to take out new things there. So this is what we have to do during our lifetime. We bring the change in the society, what Mahatma Gandhi said, be the change you want to see in the world. You have to be in the forefront. And I think the Guru Mantras have been given by the earlier speakers, the directors and the guest speaker. And you have to lead from the front if you want to be a leader, and especially a management leader. I'm sure each one of you have different dreams, but surely you should never give up your dreams and aspirations for it. Those aspirations will drive you to higher level of achievements and make your life purposeful. Here I quote a few lines from former President Kalam's address. Dream is not what you see in sleep. It is something what does not let you sleep. There are a lot of challenges now ahead of you. You are reading that India is going to be a 5 trillion economy in the near future and will be third largest economy in the world and aiming to be $35 billion economy by 2047, because now this is the aim after we attain 100 years of our independence. You are the future leaders. You have to take the lead. Now the world is looking at our country, and the country is looking at you to give new ideas of management so that we are able to manage things better and reach that stage. If you talk about the management, I think there is no area where the management is not required, be it finance, human resource, stocks, sales, hospitals also, we thought the doctors only are required. Your sports is there, and in court also we have court and case management. Because unless we manage all these things, it is not possible to run. These all ideas are there. Now, natural resources is, yes, one of the important part, environment, and for that we need good leaders in management to guide. And I can share my experience with you, because we are not management trained otherwise. And in fact, if you see, you also have experience that everybody is born with some management qualities. And the first and the foremost you see in your family only at your house, your mothers, how they manage everything. From the childhood, you must be seeing how different things she's managing. Nobody has taught her anything about the management, because we are all born managers to some extent. We are also not trained by any course in management. Yes, law we have read. We also had a lot of committees there in the high courts. On administrative side, we need to manage. There are a lot of computer committees I was heading and the other committees. So there also we need to manage a lot of human resource working in different courts. And the purchase of hardware, your software is there, some installation. So a lot of things are there. So with experience only, we could do a lot of work there, and I can share with you that purchase of hardware in Punjab and Haryana High Court, where I was there initially, used to be at the lowest of prices wherever anybody could have bought it. Because these ideas we used to get from the vendors also, from many different people, and the core for that is that be always receptive, and your communication skills have to be very good. You should be receptive to receive ideas and not sit with your closed mind anywhere. Similarly, we had different experience in J&K also, Calcutta also, and Allahabad is world's largest high court, I think. I had an opportunity to work there also, because the main mantra again is you can't live in silos and then have good management. Now I can share with you some data about the court system where we are working. How much data we are managing is all, again, management. And with IT tools, we have been able to achieve a lot of good results. If you visit the National Judicial Data Grid site, this is the site, I think, world's largest site having the data of the court system in. Because nowhere in the world you have so much of pendency of cases or so much of cases in the world. The Supreme Court has about 70,000 cases. Your high courts have about 61 lakh cases, all high courts, and the district courts about 4.41 crore cases, and being managed by about 18,000 judicial officers at different levels. This information is available on a click of button on your website and also the mobile app. Now we have another website, ESCR. Many of you may be interested in legal issues. There we have 36,000 Supreme Court judgments and 1.26 crore high court judgments uploaded on that website in a searchable engine. You can search in any mode. There are different modes of searching those judgments. Nowhere in the world you will find that. And there are a lot of other information available on these websites. After you have graduated, I think you have some moral and social responsibility also. And being a student also, at that time also, I think it should be there. Because I had been sharing with the students of law in law colleges. We have about 6.50 lakhs villages in our country. And about 5 lakh law students. So I just suggested them, why not to institution-wise, group-wise, adopt some villages nearby the college and see how you can uplift the people living there. And similarly, I think the management institutes should also adopt the nearby villages and let the students work. This will give you a lifetime experience, because India lives in villages only. Cities, yes, the real thing is in your village. So you will have the idea of the problems being faced, what you have to manage in your life, because you can't plan sitting in your drawing room. in your AC office, unless you know where the shoe is pinching. Once I was called in a program by the Institute of Cost and Works Accountants. So I thought, what is my job as a judge there? But it also has a relation. But I asked them that why can't you calculate the cost of litigation of a case and see whether it is worth to fight that case? Give those ideas to the government, because government is the major litigant here. So this is how the relation is. And presently, the average age of an Indian is 28.2 years. See, young India, you have energy. I think we can make wonders if we seriously take up all these issues. The relations of a student who pass out from any educational institution does not end there. Rather, it is beginning of a new relationship. Even as an alumni, your endeavor should always be to take the institution to new heights, so that you could always say with pride that you passed out from that institution. Whatever you achieve in your life, you should share the fruits of the achievement with your institution where you studied, so that it is passed on to the young students. Spare time for interaction with them, it motivates. Now, it is not required that you need to come personally also, because with the IT revolution, I think you can always join through VC also and share your rich experiences with your young students who are, you will be admitted in this institute. Never stop learning. This is your word. I strongly believe that and can say with confidence that you will overcome the obstacles of life with your competence, and each one of you shall touch new heights of life. My good wishes and blessings to all of you. I once again congratulate all the students who got their degrees in different streams at this convocation. From this premier educational institution, I wish you all the success in life. But, quote, what William Arthur Ward said, a mediocre teacher tells, a good teacher explains, the superior teacher demonstrates, and a great teacher inspires. And this is what you have been done. You have been inspired to do more. And this is what this institution had been doing. For parents and teachers, what Rabindranath Tagore said, the roots below the earth claim no reward for making the branches fruitful. So this is what the respect our teachers and the parents deserve, because they never claim anything. You must have seen the gardeners in a good garden. He never claims that he has done anything, though he will maintain the plants and he will go and enjoy that. Professor Sharma had touched the issue about the respect to the parents. I think this is the area where we are really concerned, and the parliament had to step in to enact a law regarding maintenance of parents and Syrian citizens act in the year 2007. Just read the preamble of that act. So this is really something which we all need to do. We have seen a lot of examples. The sons and daughters who are there, they are all well educated, well placed in life, but their parents living in old age home. And they occasionally go to that old age home for celebration of their birthdays or anything. So this is what is happening. This is something we all should be concerned with. I will end again with respect to the teachers who have guided you through your course here. What was said, Guru Govind Dho Khade Kaku Lage Paaye, Balihari Guru Aapne Jin Govind Diyo Milaye. This is what the status of a teacher is. He is above even the Almighty, because he has guided you. I think with all these few words, and again congratulating you for your achievements, I take back my seat. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. May I now request the chairman BOG to officially close the convocation ceremony.
I declare the convocation closed.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem.
Janaganamana Adhinayaka Jaya Hai Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchala Jaladhi Taranga Tava Shubha Name Jage शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Ladies and gentlemen, the academic procession will now leave the venue. You may please stand up and remain standing till all the members of the procession left the venue.
Vande Mataram Sujalam Sufalam Malayaj Sheetalam Sasya Shyamalam Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini Pullakusumita Madala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram
Please join us for lunch.
Vande Mataram Sujalam Sufalam Malayaj Sheetalam Sasya Shyamalam Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini Pullakusumita Drumadala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Sujalam Sufalam Malayaj Sheetalam Sasya Shyamalam Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini Pullakusumita Drumadala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Sujalam
Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini Pullakusumita Drumadala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Sujana Sukhada Malayaja Sheetala Sasya Shyamala Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini Pullakusumita Drumadala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Sujana Sukhana Malayaja Sheetala Sasya Shyamala Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini
All of you are requested to please submit your robes. There's a counter just outside the venue. So please submit your robes.
Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Sujana Sukhana Malayaja Sheetala Sasya Shyamala Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini Pullakusumita Drumadala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhada
Hello students! Hello! Please once more your head put on upside please It's for recording only, please.
Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Sujana Sukhana Malayaja Sheetala Sasya Shyamala Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini Pullakusumita Drumadala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram
सुखदाम्बरदाम मातरम् वन्दे मातरम्।